everybody. How are you doing? Awesome. I think I got the lunch crowd, so maybe we're just like, we're bringing our energy back up, but that's okay. Accounting will do the trick, I promise. Awesome. Well, welcome to our session today. As mentioned, my name is Megan, and I'm the product marketing manager for Clio's financial performance products. Welcome to our session all about Clio's QuickBooks Online integration. I can already sense the buzz of excitement in the room. Accounting is often the favorite topic of ClioCon. But in all seriousness, show me by a raise of hand here, who enjoys accounting? Amazing, now I know exactly where the bookkeepers and accountants are in the room. But truly, you're all here already, so you understand how important accounting is to running your practice and running it with confidence. Now, my goal for today's session is to break down what the QuickBooks Online integration does, some best practices or some tips, and a couple of reasons why it works the way it works. I mean, ultimately, this will help you run your practice with more confidence. Think of this session as your accounting Cole's Notes, if you will. When seamlessly integrated, Clio and QuickBooks Online communicate automatically, seamlessly, and securely from one source of truth. Today, our agenda, we'll be covering the basics of Clio and QuickBooks Online, what happens in each place. I'll also go over some standout features that we recommend law firms take full advantage of. We'll touch on Trust Accounting 101, trust checks, and of course, a necessary part if you work with trust funds, and that's reconciliation. So the benefits that a seamless QuickBooks Online integration bring to your life are plenty. But if I had to distill them down into just a couple of benefits, these would be them. Number one, you save time. That's the most important commodity, usually. And I can say this confidently, no one likes to enter data manually multiple times in different places. That's often the source of that accounting headache. Number two is compliance, and that's a really big one. As you know, the jurisdictions in which you operate have certain rules and regulations that you need to follow in order to maintain compliance. Now, that can be time-consuming and complex to stay on top of. So, not to mention, that also introduces a bunch of, you know, potential manual errors. And the consequences for that non-compliance, I don't need to be the one to remind you, but they can be steep. They can be fines, suspension, even disbarment. And the third big benefit I'd like to highlight here is that you get some really rich financial insights when every piece of that financial puzzle is all in one place. We have your accounting, your billing, and your payments or collections all centralized through Clio. And that's imperative to managing your cash flow and running your business. So, that all sounds amazing, wonderful, but how does it work? That's the question of the 15 minutes I have here, so let's dig into it. What do you do in Clio? Well, we're gonna track our time or billable hours. We're gonna create and send those activities, which can be shared by email, text messaging, the client portal. We're also going to process payments in Clio for bills or trust requests. And then we'll record those client or matter transactions. Finally, as you might have heard, as of this month, you'll also be able to do your trust reconciliation right in Clio. None of that happens in QuickBooks Online. What does happen there are expense and general or back-end accounting related activities. So let's suppose you're recording your expenses. Maybe they're firm-related expenses like rent or payroll. That's QuickBooks Online. Maybe they're client or matter-specific expenses like court filing fees. Also QuickBooks Online. This is the spot you'll run your business accounting and also print your checks. All right, so now that we know exactly what activities need to originate where, why is that important? Well, mainly because for the syncs to work, information flows best in certain directions. Just as you might tell a story from beginning to middle to end, this integration works when information flows in the right direction. We're going to go over each of these syncs one by one here. So follow along with me from the top. Your contacts are going to sync from Clio to QuickBooks Online. That's the way we recommend. Bills and payments is a one-way sync from Clio to QuickBooks Online. Your trust, that is a one-way sync from, let me hear it, Clio to QuickBooks Online, exactly. And then we come to the fourth sync I'd like to cover today, and that's your hard costs. You'll notice that arrow goes in the opposite direction. Why? Well, simply remember, QuickBooks Online is where we go for expense-related activities first. So, contacts are one of those syncs that we recommend flow from Clio to QuickBooks Online. And remember, this is only applicable to those who have approved bills. That's really important. Now, a tip that we at Clio recommend you use is to have this sync handy so that you're not duplicating your data entry in both places. Clio actually looks through your QuickBooks Online contacts, and when there's no match, and Clio will look by full name and by email address, upon discovering there's no match, Clio does the work for you to create the contact. You'll see in this example here, when Clio creates that contact for you, you'll see in brackets, Clio and the ID number. Now, the bills and payments sync is probably one of the most popular syncs or pieces of functionality within this integration. I mean, most firms who use this integration love this sync simply because it allows you to bring over details from your bills, like discounts or taxes, all without having to enter it in multiple places multiple times. And again, this only applies to those approved bills. Now, best practice is to actually record each payment or use payment recording through Clio Payments, because that automatically records and associates those transactions with your bills in Clio already. All right, now we come to the trust sync. So as you know, when you receive or request funds ahead of doing the work, that would be unearned or otherwise known as trust funds. Now this is unique to law firms, and Clio plus QuickBooks Online really understand the nuances here. And we find that this is one of the places it really shines. It protects both you and your clients. Now, I personally like to think of this feature of the integration as Clio being the lens affixed to your QuickBooks Online camera. Both are important to take that perfect picture. Now, to use this sync, I'm going to go over one principle I'd like you to keep in mind. And that's that your debits and credits should balance. So keeping that in mind, in QuickBooks Online, we're going to set up first a trust account. That is where you're going to debit or first record those funds from your client. But because we need to balance, we need a credit as well. So we'll also need to create a trust liability account, also in QuickBooks Online. And that's where we're going to credit and balance out where we already recorded those trust funds. After that, it's a simple matter of connecting them in Clio settings and choosing which accounts you'd like to sync. You'll choose a sync date for when those transactions should start syncing, and then you'll want to build a reconciliation strategy around what you've decided. Now, trust transactions can look like a few things. They can be trust deposits or disbursements, matter-to-matter trust transfers, or trust request payments. The one-way sync from Clio to QuickBooks Online brings those transactions over and records them in QuickBooks as journal entries, which is typically, again, in the trust liability account. Now, check printing is another really important part about working with funds held in trust. Suppose you need to disburse funds on a client's behalf. You'll want to export trust check printing from Clio to QuickBooks Online by simply hitting disburse funds, and then you'll check off print check via QuickBooks Online. Once that's saved, you'll then see the transaction along with a QuickBooks generated check sitting in your QuickBooks Online account. Now, one of my favorite things about this integration is that Clio is smart. It knows to safeguard your funds in case the amount that you've input is incorrect. And the reason why it knows this is because it already knows what's in the bank thanks to that connection with QuickBooks Online. This protects you from overdrawing on your clients' accounts, and in turn, it protects your clients. Now, if you're one of the firms in our room today who has not yet set up this integration, I'd like to take 2 minutes flat just to show you how easy it can be. All right, start the clock. You're gonna get into your Clio account and you'll click Settings and then Bill Syncing. Then you'll click on Connect to QuickBooks Online and a pop-up window will come up prompting you to sign in to your QuickBooks Online account. That actually establishes the connection. Then all you'll need to do is simply configure the settings according to what syncs you'd like to use. Now, Clio actually maps to products and services in QuickBooks Online so that the way a client's bill is divvied up makes sense financially across both Clio and QuickBooks Online. Sync forward dates can also be chosen for trust transactions and for any hard costs being input into QuickBooks Online that will then sync over to Clio. Remember that fourth sync going the opposite way. You can see here in these examples where the sync forward dates are found in Clio settings for QuickBooks Online. Now, a big part of your accounting strategy if you work with funds in trust is, of course, trust reconciliation. And I'd be remiss if we didn't touch on that very key part of the puzzle. Now, as we know, it's required in your jurisdictions, and compliance consequences are pretty steep, or rather, I should say, non-compliance consequences. And those can be, as mentioned, fines, suspension, even disbarment. New in Clio, I'm super excited to announce, if this is your first time hearing about it, or just follow up if you've already heard it again, that we have a trust reconciliation pilot available already in your account in Clio Manage. Now, the trust reconciliation pilot ultimately lets you reconcile your accounts in the same place you already manage your firm. The big benefits to this is that you save time. Again, that really big commodity. You're doing it all in one place. It also removes the risk for manual errors. Another one is it keeps you compliant. And the last one, and this is a really big one in my books, it keeps 10 years of your reconciliation reports all in Clio. There's no more need to go to that corner office and dig through all those banker boxes. It's just right here where you already do the rest of your workflows. Now, the way that it does it is that Clio Manage will actually allow you to match your trust account transactions to your bank account. And you'll be able to do this in a fraction of the time. All right, congratulations. Give yourselves a pat on the back. You've survived 15 minutes of accounting. Now, if you're just looking down at your notebooks and realizing, I wish I had some amazing takeaways from this session, Don't worry, I got you covered. Number one, the sync, or rather integration, between Clio and QuickBooks Online is not complicated. Just remember that almost everything flows from Clio to QuickBooks Online. The only thing going the opposite direction is your hard costs. These syncs save you time, and it really helps you manage your money and your cash flow so that you can keep doing what you're doing. And finally, the trust reconciliation pilot is now open and available for you to reconcile right in Clio. It was an absolute pleasure digging into accounting with you today. If you have any questions about the QuickBooks Online integration, feel free to head on right over to the product lab where we'll be happy to help. Otherwise, my name is Megan, and enjoy the rest of day two.